Well, folks, it's time to kick it old school. So you can feel cool. Give it to me, baby. Baby. Yeah.
Light, dark, light, dark, light, dark. All the way down. Looks great.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back to Garage Gear. I'm JB. And if you've been thinking about getting one of these Toro Time Master striping kits, then this video is for you. I'm going to try to cover as much as I can here in this video so that way you can make a smart purchase. I'm going to go over the ups,
the downs,
the pluses, the minuses, the benefits, the drawbacks, and everything in between. Now, I purchased this Toro Time Master striping kit a few weeks ago and installed it on this Toro Time Master. If you're interested in checking that video out, check the link below in the description. Since then, I've really put this Toro Time Master through its paces to really make sure that it does a good job striping the lawn. Also, if you're interested in checking out how I care for the rest of my lawn during the season, check out my video playlist titled Lawn Fertilizing Program. So let's talk about all the things that I like about this Toro Time Master striping kit. The first thing that I like is that it actually turns really well. It pivots nicely like the trailer on a truck. Compared to the last one that I had that was a DIY project, that one was just a straight pipe, and that pipe did not turn well. It made this machine very difficult to steer. Another thing that I like about this Toro Time Master striping kit is that it is easy on, easy off. If I want it off, all I gotta do is disengage the blade, take it off, no tools required. Smooth stripes, you betcha. Take a look. Nice smooth surface, and this comb does a pretty good job of breaking up any clumps that it may come across in the lawn, so that way they don't get squished flat onto the turf. Another thing that I like is that this roller is far enough up that it will not hit my feet. Now, I'm about 5'8", 5'9", somewhere in that department, but if I was a taller person, maybe over 6 foot, this may be a concern with longer legs, but ultimately, this thing does stay pretty tight to the mower. Also, if I install the bag, it is out of the way of that as well, just beneath it. Now let's talk about the things that I don't like about this striping kit. So now over here, let me show you something. I hope you can see it and this camera picks it up, but I have done already this area right in here. The reason is because this is only about maybe 8 feet wide, and turning the mower can be a little bit difficult, especially in this tight space. So my recommendation, do not cut tight spaces with the Time Master striper, because it will kind of be a set of clunky turns as you're trying to make your passes. So what I usually do is I pre-cut these areas, and then I just go up and down, do my stripes in the wide open spaces. So I know earlier I mentioned that this thing turns easy, and that is true for wide turns. Tight turns force the striper up and over the frame, causing it to clank against the height adjusters on the lawnmower. This is not a monumental problem, but it does slow down the turn a little bit. Now, I'm no engineer, but I also think that the frame that attaches to the mower should be triangular in shape to match that of the striper. This could possibly allow for better turning. Just a thought, Toro. So by pulling the Time Master striping kit behind your lawnmower, you are actually increasing the weight of the lawnmower, and therefore going uphill can be a little bit more of a challenge. Yes, this does put a little bit more strain on the transmission, but the Toro Time Master handles it quite well. So now let me show you something. I already went down this way, down my edge of my property line here against my neighbor's yard, and that's going to actually set a really dark stripe with that striping kit all the way down. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back up right against it here with a white stripe, and then I'll come back down and I'll keep doing this circle right here a couple of times to really make this stripe as dark as I can possibly get it. This is the best way to show the neighbors that you have the best lawn on the block. So now at this point, the neighbors have to know they're being dominated. I mean, come on. Now, another thing with the Time Master striping kit is that sunlight plays a big role in how well your stripes become visible. So I'm doing a very straightforward up and down path. My hope is that this camera can actually pick it up with the right amount of sunlight. Let's get striping.
Yeah.
Woo! So before I had tons of cloud cover and actually the stripes were showing up pretty nicely. Now I have this odd angle of sunlight, so it's kind of throwing off the definition of the stripe. So here's my plan. I'm gonna cut again and I'm just gonna go over in the same direction and really double up these stripes and really press them down nice and firm. That way they look really tight and really nice. Well, everybody, the striping kit does its job once again. Take a look. So here we are now after a double cut, and you can kind of see that these lines are a little bit darker. Again, I'm still fighting an angle of sunlight that's coming this way, so it's not showing them off quite as I'd like them to, but you can definitely tell that they are more pressed and more defined. Here on my side lot, I purposely did not use the striping kit over here, and all you can see is the wheel marks. That's it, no defined stripes. So you kind of see the difference between the two. Take a look at all those stripes. Now, can you get away with just striping the lawn one time? Definitely. Does it look even better with two passes? Absolutely. So now, if you ask me, is this striping kit worth it? My answer is definitely yes. It's just one more weapon in my arsenal to make my lawn the best on the block. If you found this video helpful, give me one of these. Be sure to click the subscribe button down below so you stay up to date on all my latest content.
Thanks for checking out Garage Gear, and I'll see you in the garage.